Hi, I'm Ben, and this is a tutorial for the ukulele for Ariana Grande's Thank You Next, which sounds, thought I'd end up with Sean, like this, but he wasn't a match. Wrote some songs about Ricky, now I listen and laugh, even almost got married. And for Pete, I'm so thankful, wish I could say thank you to Malcolm, cause he was an angel, one taught me love. One taught me patience and one taught me pain. Now I'm so amazing. And we're going to have a look at this together. In this tutorial, of course, we're going to have a look at the chords, the strumming, but also this little riff that you can learn to play. Which is super easy and actually very similar to what comes up throughout the whole original song. So it's quite fun to play on the ukulele. But first things first, oh by the way, thank you to the patrons of my ukulele tutorials and travels making this video possible. You can become one of them and get the song sheet if you want, link in the description. Let's start with the chords. They're here, they're these ones. Now that's something that's going to be really fun in this song, is that we're not going to play it with the more boring versions of the chords, F, E7, A minor, C7. We're going to jazz it up a bit because that's a lot of the character of this song, which sounds very sort of pop band 90s. And we're going to use an F and then an E7, but with a higher ring finger, meaning we're playing 1, 2, open, 3. And then an A minor 7, which means no fingers at all. And then a C7 with the ninth and without a C, which is played like this. Open, second, open, first. And with these four chords looped 10,000 times, you can then play the entire song. Exactly, nothing else needed apart from a bit of singing and rhythm. So let's have a look at this loop. La da 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 da, F, F, like this. And then E7 with the sixth. And then A minor 7, no fingers apart from this one, the thumb. And then C7 with the ninth, which is like a C7 but with your middle finger also. Actually, it's like an F, but one string down. And then back to F, meaning your fingers don't have to move that much. C7 to F. This is the beginning of the verse, and we're going to start singing on this note, the open G string, which is the green one here on my pineapple, and we start singing on that one. Thought I'd end up with Sean, and the F on Sean, and then back to the same note, but he wasn't a match, and the E7, 9 on match. And then wrote some songs about Ricky. Ricky on the A minor 7. Now I listen and laugh. C7 on the laugh. I'm not going to say the names C7, 9, A minor 7. I'm just going to say the simple names, but we're always going to play them like this. Let's continue. This note. Even almost got married. F. And for Pete, I'm so E7 thankful. Wish I could say thank you to A minor 7 on Malcolm, cause he was a C7 angel. And then on to the pre-chorus. The pre-chorus is actually these notes to sing if you need some sort of help. One taught me love. So it's one taught, it's these two open strings, really, the two first open strings. One taught. G, C. One taught me, and then you play the F on love. One taught me love, one taught me E7 patience, one taught me pain. Now I'm so amazing, I've loved and I've lost, but that's not what I see. So look what I got, look what you taught me, and for that I say. And then the chorus starts in that point. Good job if you've made it all through the pre-chorus. The thing about this pre-chorus to sing is that you've got one taught, the two notes that we've talked about. One taught me love, one taught me patience. Even on the E7 it's shuns, which is a low G. So if ever you don't find this low note in the pre-chorus, it's always a G here. So you can help yourself by plucking this string. Shuns. One taught me love, one taught me patience. It's quite funny because we're not actually playing that note. We're playing a G sharp here, but we're singing a G flat, not flat, square, the one between flat and sharp. Anyway, we're playing a normal G. And on to the chorus. We'll still do just the chords, and after that we'll have a look at the strumming for the verse and the chorus. And the chorus sounds like this with just the chords. And for that I say thank you. Next E7. Thank you. Next A-7. Thank you. Next. I'm so, oh so grateful for my ex. Thank you. Next E7. Thank you. Next A-7. Thank you. Next. I'm so, oh so, spend more time with my friends. And then we go on to the second verse. Just to guide you through the singing of the chorus, the way that it works is that we've got four beats per chord. One, two, three, four. And the chord falls on the first beat, obviously. Well, that's what usually happens. And then the thank, your thank you next, falls on the second beat. You falls on the, just before the third beat, and next on the fourth beat. So it goes like this. One, two, three, four, say thank you. Next, E7. Thank you. Next, E7. Thank you. Next. I'm so, oh so grateful for my ex. Sorry about not swearing in this one, but I just thought, you know, I'll sing it the way she sings it when she's on TV. Sometimes I swear too, but I mean, my cousin could be watching this. So now what we need is a strumming pattern. So I suggest this one that you can use for the verse and the pre-chorus, and also the chorus if you want. And it's down, down, up, up, down, up. And that's one strumming pattern per chord. So with the loop, it'll sound like this. F, down, up, up, down, up. E7, down, up, up, down, up. A-7, down, up, up, down, up. C7, down, up, up, down, up. F, down, up, up, down, up. E7, down, up, up, down, up. A-7, down, up. And with the singing, this'll go. Thought I'd end up with Sean, but he wasn't a man. Wrote some songs about Ricky. Now I listen and laugh. Even almost got married. And for Pete I'm so grateful. Wish I could say thank you to Malcolm, 'cause he was an angel. One taught me love. One, and feel free to, as you feel more comfortable with the rhythm, to add more groove and more energy in the strumming hand. But make sure you always have a constant movement. Not down, down, up, up, down, up. Down, down, up, but more down, down, up, da dee. So constant movement, and you can add a bit more. One, well, one taught me love, one taught me patience, and one taught me pain. Now I'm so amazing, I've loved and I've lost, but that's not what I see, so look at. And then onto the chorus. You can strum this by actually strumming twice as fast, instead of strumming this rhythm. Down, up, down, up, down, up. You can strum down, up, down, up, down, up, da, 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 da. So this needs a bit of practice, but if you play down, 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 up, down, up, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, slowly. Down, 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 up, down, up, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, 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 up, down, up, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Then that will work. I mean, to be honest, it never really matters the down and the ups. What matters is having the constant movement and that it sounds good and that you're relaxed, shoulders are relaxed. Arm is relaxed, and then it sounds good. Anyway, we're gonna still do it. And it's like this. Down, 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 up, down, up, up, down, up, down, up, change. Up, down, down, up, down, up, up, down, up, down, up, change. Down, up, down, up, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. And with the lyrics. And for that I say thank you, next. Thank you, next. Thank you, next. I'm so, oh so grateful for my ex. Thank you. Next, thank you, next, thank you, next. I'm so, oh so, spend more time with my friends. So why did I choose this strumming pattern? Because it's quite practical to play and sing at the same time, because you've got the chord, and then thank you. So it's down, up, down, you, thank you. And so in slow-mo it sounds like this. Thank you. Next. Thank you. Next. Thank you. Next. I'm so, oh so grateful for my ex. Okay. Okay, let's move on to not another lover. I mean to verse number two. Verse number two with the strumming pattern and the first one, I mean. Down, down, up, up, down, up. Spend more time with my friends. I ain't worried about nothing. Plus I met someone else. We haven't better discussions. I know they say I move on too fast, but this one gonna last. Cause her name is Ari, and I'm so good with that, so good with that. She taught me love, she taught me patience, and she deals with pain. Anyway, and then it continues with that. So with what you've learnt in the first part, that should be easy enough to sing again. Of course, remember that the high note is the open G, and the low note the second string open, and the very low note is the G again. So use these open strings if you can't find the notes to sing. There you go, you should be all set to learn the song. Now let's have a look at the high up motif that comes out throughout the whole song. Two, three, four. So the way this goes is that you basically have three chords. This one, the F major 7, which is 5-5-5-7. And then you have this one, which is the E7, which is 7-8-7-7. And then you have the A minor 7, which you have to play downwards because you want to make this note on the green string here, the bottom string, stand out to have that melody. And that is 7-5-7-5. And then just add your middle finger here to make 5-7-6-7. And then you have a C7 here. And then what you have to do is add some notes. So on the F major 7, on 5-5-5-7, you go 7-5-7-10, 7-10-7-10. That's 7 and then 10 on the string underneath, and then back to 7 and then 10 here, which is the G not sharp with a G sharp at the same time. Listen to this. That's what's pretty cool. And then we play downwards the chord that we just had a look at. And it sounds like this. And you have to be able to hear the and it's not it's so the tida is always on the beat of the one or the three. Two, four, and then just two chords. So I hope that you get that, it's not too hard. And a quick word about the key of the song. I mean, what is the original key or height at which this song is sung? Well, it's very close to this one, but it's not F, it's actually, we start with a G flat. So if you want to sing with the recording of Ariana, all you have to do is bring your ukulele half a step higher, meaning tuning instead of G, C, E, A, you tune A flat, D flat, F, B flat, and you go like this. And then you can sing in the original key. Thought I'd end up with Sean, but he wasn't a match. Wrote some songs about Ricky, and now I listen and laugh. Well, there you go. I hope you find this tutorial useful. If you do, let it be known. See you for more. And if you want to join the generous patrons supporting these lessons, you're more than welcome to. The link's in the description. So is the link to buy this little pineapple, by the way, from Clown Music, which you can have lots of colourful fun with this Christmas season. Bye bye.